Hi everyone, I'm Jay Zims, and I'm here to show you how to make Twitch emotes for free. Let's get started. Alright, so next up you'll need a photo to use for your emote. Here's a sample picture I took for my own Twitch channel earlier today. Since emotes are displayed at such a small size, I recommend taking the photo close up and with as much lighting as possible in order to capture the most detail. It will also speed up the cropping process if you take the photo against a solid background. Don't be afraid to go big with the expressions. Any exaggerated details you can add to your photo will make for a more interesting emote because they are so small. Now that we have our photo, let's crop it. Go ahead and open your photo in Gimp to begin the cropping process. Emotes use a square aspect ratio, so first crop the photo to match this. You can set that here by using 1:1. And then just outline your emote. Get it as tight as possible. And then the Enter key will do the crop. Alright, next we can use a scissor tool to create an outline for the emote. I recommend using the interactive boundary setting so you can see a preview of the crop line. The preview of the crop line with that setting enabled is yellow until you release the mouse click, and it allows you to line up where you want each point a little easier. For example, if it was gonna be a huge miss, we can dial it back and add more points. It doesn't need to be super accurate because we can clean it up after the crop. Just want it to be close enough. Also, these are displayed pretty small, so little rough edges won't matter. But here's a good example. So here, it got a little too much on the inside, so we can do Control Z to undo and just add more points. So the more points you add, the less guessing it has to do for finding the line to follow. And see here, I can see that the yellow preview line is a little bit outside, so I can just add another point. All right, so once you have your outline, just click on the inside. You can see it goes to this dotted line, which means you have your selection ready to go. So you can just right-click, edit, copy, right-click, edit, paste, and of course your copy-paste keyboard shortcuts will work for whatever system you're on. And you can see on the right, a new layer has been pasted. Just go ahead and right-click on that and say to new layer. So now we have two layers. The original layer is not really needed anymore, so we can go ahead and delete that. And we're left with a perfectly square image containing our emote. It's a little rough because the selection tool is not perfect, so here I like to take the eraser tool and just go clean it up. I like to optimize for smooth edges. Most of this stuff won't be visible on your emote because the max size for them is 112 pixels, but now's a good time to clean up any rough edges with the eraser tool that you have as a result of your selection. White boundaries seem to stand out a lot, so I like to make sure that those are gone. Like in here, We don't want any sore thumbs. All right, that looks pretty good. So now, that's basically all there is to it. So now that you have it all cleaned up, all that's left to do is export it to the acceptable sizes for Twitch. And you can do that here. File, export as. PNG. This way we can preserve the transparent background. And we're able to just use the extension because you can see that the file type is chosen by the extension. And the defaults are fine. All right, so now we need the sizes. You can do that from the image, scale image. And there are three sizes Twitch requires. The first is 112 pixels by 112 pixels. And I recommend using 72 pixels per inch. Since this is for web, 72 pixels per inch is all you need. So go ahead and scale that. File, export as. And I usually like to add in the dimensions to the file name. So 112. Image, scale, 56 by 56. Scale, export. So you just have to do this for all three sizes. Final size is 28, so scale 28 by 28. And there you have it. Your emotes in all the sizes required by Twitch. Ready to go. And that's all there is to it, folks. Have fun and get creative with it. I'd love to see your emote creations. If you found this video helpful, like and subscribe below and catch me on Twitch at twitch.tv/jzims. Happy streaming, everyone.